And welcome back. So today's tutorial, I received one of the comment from one of the subscriber on my channel that can we show an image and custom image in an info message. So he was having a client, and that client has a requirement that on an incident form he wants to show some custom icons in the info message to give more clarity to the user, right? My first thought was that this was going to be a piece of cake, right? Since I know that info message means basically we can go with on display business rule, right? For onload client script or client script could contain HTML. So info message basically supports HTML. Okay, so I began down my path. Okay, let's see how we can achieve it. So first of all, let's go view. The use case for today is like we will try to add an icon in the info message to give more idea to the end user. Okay, this is a pretty amazing idea. Okay, so let's go to the icon. Those who don't know, so we have action icons over here. Okay, in action icon you can see a variety of icon which is used throughout the ServiceNow instance. So there are around 400 plus icons. Okay, if you have not watched my video on the same, you can watch, the link is as shown above. Okay, so this all are black and white icons. Let's do it this way. Let's try to add some colorful icon. Okay, so let's go to Google. Okay, which website we can use to get the icons. Okay, so we will give free icons download. Yeah, we have flat icon, right? Okay, so basically I want to give a message like sleepy. So the intention is like whenever we are getting an incident, we will give this sleepy that. Okay. This one. Let's use this one. Okay. This icon. Let's try to use. We'll go with the free download. Perfect. It should. It got down. It's sleepy.png. Now let's look at this image first. Okay. So I will do show in folder. Okay, it's quite a big image. It's 512 by 500. We don't want this big image, right? Let's resize it out. So I will go open with paint, resize. I'll do it 20 by 20. Okay, I think this is fine. It got saved. Okay, done. Now this seems to be fine. Okay, now you will use this icon in our instance. Okay, so again coming back to our instance. Okay, so what, first of all we have to import that particular icon which we have downloaded in our ServiceNow instance, right? So how to do that? Okay, so we have to go to system UI. In system UI we will have and module called images. Okay, so let's go to the images. Here we can add our custom images. Okay, I was doing WhatsApp integration recently, so yeah, that's why you can see this over here. So yeah, put the category as general. Okay, let's give it a name. We'll give a name sleepy. Okay, sleepy. And we have to also give the extension of that image. Okay, so it's png, right? So sleepy.png. you can give any name over here. Click to add image. Okay, now you can simply browse that image out. So I will type sleepy. Come on. Okay. So you can see now we got an image over here, and this is the HTML syntax to be used. Okay, we can use this HTML syntax and I think it should work fine with this. Okay, so let's see. So we will go, we know basic HTML, right? So let's create, let's go to incident table and let's create and on display business rule itself, so that it will load this particular info message every time the forms get loaded, right? So I will right click, configure, let's duplicate this tab, okay, and then because we need this, so right click, configure, business rule. In business rule, I will give name as display sleepy incident. I will give some random name, okay? You can check on advanced, so the advanced tab will come. We will give when, so we will give it display. So for those who don't know, display business rule runs before the client script also. So this is the first script which runs on the load of the form. So we will give display business rule. Whenever there is a display business rule, there will be no insert update things, okay? Because it slows, it runs on a form load, right? And here we can add the code. Let's add gs dot add info message. And let's use normal HTML. So in HTML, how do we give the image source? Like image, okay, source equal to sleepy dot png. Okay, as this particular this thing is in this instance itself, okay. Let's use double inverted comma because you have used single inverted comma at the end, right? So sleepy. So now we got the image and we can give it a message like no incident again. I am sleepy right now. This is my thought when I get some incidents, okay? So let's put exclamation, this is my thoughts, okay? So let's put some exclamation marks. So now probably this should display a message, right? When the incident form is loaded, let's see whether it works. So I will open one of the incident and let's see if we are getting that message out. So we are getting the message no incident again, I am sleepy right now, okay? But it doesn't display the image, okay? You must be thinking all done right, okay? Well, not so fast, okay? Apparently ServiceNow doesn't display the image correctly when it is called in this manner, okay? This I recently encountered, okay? In order to work around this behavior, we have to perform some inline CSS, okay? That is cascade style sheet, right? In order to display it inline, okay, we can add some more code, okay? So let's make it inline. So now we have image, let's add it. We'll give style equal to display, okay, style equal to display colon inline, and we will make it important. So what exactly important does it will override other inline CSS, right? Important, let's give width how much, 20 pixel for now, 20 pixel, okay, and yeah, that's done. So we have added a style, this is an inline style, display is equal to inline, important, and we have given width for the scene, okay, and then we have source equal to image this, and now it should work. So what we did, we have just added inline CSS around that particular image, okay? So let's save it out and let's see if it works right now. This small thing, okay, but actually it's pretty amazing, okay, if we can achieve it. So I have saved it out. Okay, let's refresh the form, reload the form, whatever you got. And now you can see this beautiful image over here. Okay, isn't it sound amazing? Okay, you can show it like, no, there is no incident again. I am sleepy right now, right? So this is for Bhushan. So in this way, Bhushan, we can add image. Okay, image in the info message, in the error message. Okay, hope you like this video. It was helpful. It's making info message more user friendly. Okay, and people are getting more attached to it. You can use the existing images which are there in ServiceNow instance, or you can add your own like I have added. Okay, so that's all for today's tutorial. Be there in this journey of ServiceNow learning. Okay, if you have this kind of requirements, right, please drop a comment and I will try to create a video on the same, because I am also learning through that only. Okay, till then, like, follow, subscribe, and stay safe, stay happy, and have a nice day. Thank you.